Dear student, today I am going to discuss about the tool signature and tool geometry. Before going to the machining operation, we should have a clear idea about the tool geometry and the tool signature also. Tool geometry and the cutting tools play very important roles for achieving the effectiveness, efficiency, and overall economy of machining. Because if there is a huge alteration or a change of the different angles of the tool geometry, then it may cause a huge loss or bad effect or impression on the machining performance. According to the cutting tools, there are single point cutting tools, double point cutting tools, and multi point cutting tools. The single point cutting tools, such like that, turning tools, shaping tools, planing tools, slotting and boring tools, etc. The double cutting tools, that is the drill or drill bit. On the drill bit, the two leaves act as a cutting edge and the fruit also. In the case of multi point cutting tool, there are milling cutters, notching tools, hobs, and the grinding wheel. The grinding wheel, there are the so many abrasive particles properly distributed over the grinding wheel surface, and those act as the cutting edges. That is why grinding wheels can be fallen under the category of multi-point cutting tool. What is tool signature? As I have earlier said, there are the different angles, important angles, which play a huge role on the machining performance. And the tool signature is a numerical code that describes all the key angles of a given cutting tool. For making us well convenient about the angles of the cutting tool, it is designated or represented by the standardized abbreviation form. We will discuss in the later on. There are the seven elements in the tool signature. These are the seven elements of the tool signature, which have the great role on the betterment of the performance of the machining operations. The first one is back break angle, second side break angle, then end relief angle, side relief angle, end cutting edge angle, side cutting edge angle, and nose radius. All play a huge role on the machining performance. These are the 3D views of the cutting tool. You can see here, this is the cutting point or the nose. Which is actually cutting point, and where the two cutting edges, the end cutting edge and side cutting edge, meets together. And this cutting edge is in directly touch with the workpiece and helps in the required machining operation. And thus we get the chips coming out of the workpiece material. This is the end cutting edge. This is the side cutting edge, side flank, frontal flank. This is the face of the cutting tool. This is the shank and face. on the face. Face is actually part of the cutting tool. The first part was the cutting point, then the face, this face. The face is defined as the portion which situates between the cutting point and the shank of the cutting tool. The face is named because whenever the chips coming out of the machining zone, then it directly confronts with the surface, and this face helps in exit of the easier way, such that the chips can make an easier exit path and always by exiting the chips freely, there is a reduction of the any extra chip load or chip pressure, and indirectly also the face helps in distributing the temperature gradient along the region, and the cutting tool life is increased. This is a shank. Shank is a portion which situates just at the back side or rear side of the face, and which is tightly and rigidly held or supported under the action of the tool holder. This is the flank portion, which has a great role on performance of the machining. This flank is situated just adjacent and below the cutting edge. This is the side cutting edge or principal cutting edge, and this is the end cutting edge or auxiliary cutting edge. What is side cutting edge or principal cutting edge? Principal cutting edge means at the time of operation, the portion of the cutting tool which in maximum portion is in touch with the job and helps in the machining operation, that is called the principal cutting edge. And one of the most important part of the tool is this nose radius. This nose radius, it is a curved region or radius formed between the intersection of the two cutting edge, that is end cutting edge and side cutting edge. Because of the presence of this curvature or radius, the heat produced at the time of operation can be easily distributed throughout this radius, and also stress concentration factor is also reduced. For that case, the tool life is comparatively increased, and it imparts the better surface finish also. This magnitude can vary between 0.4 to 1.6 millimeter, and if this radius was not provided, then there might have been a chance of reducing the life of the tool, because if this radius was not provided, then it would have been a sharp edge. Due to the sharp edge, the stress level and the stress concentration level would have been much higher, and the tool can damage and the tool life would have been reduced. This is the front view, top view and side view of a single point cutting tool. And you can see the slope of this rake surface or face. The angle between the inclination of the rake surface and the line parallel to the base is called the rake angle. This is the rake angle. if this inclination of the face goes downward on the cutting point, then it is called the positive break. Generally, positive break is utilized for machining of ductile materials and soft materials. And whenever this slope of the face goes upwards from the cutting point, it will turn into the negative break. The negative break is harder one and more strong and utilized for the machining of hard material. This is the clearance angle. It plays a great role in the machining operation. This angle is produced by the flank surface and the line perpendicular drawn from the cutting point whenever the front view is taken. Because of the presence of this angle, the extra rubbing action between the flank surface and the workpiece surface is minimized, and also it can direct the thrust force in a well phenomenon. That is, the distribution of the thrust force is maintained well by this clearance angle, and indirectly also due to the lesser amount of friction, friction is reduced and the heat also reduced, and thus in helping for the distribution of the extra heat energy and increases the tool life. This is the leap angle or angle of keenness of the tool. It is the angle formed between the face and the flank of the tool. Its angle value may be 70 to 80 degrees. It is a hill which is formed between the intersection between the flank surface and the base surface, and it is a base which holds the forces and the extra load of the chips and all the cutting forces and the weight of the tool. All is maintained by this base. This is the top view. The face or a rake surface, this is an in-cutting edge angle. In-cutting edge angle is value maybe in between the 3 degree to 15 degree, 15 degree. This angle is produced by the in-cutting edge and the line perpendicular drawn from the cutting point whenever the top view is taken. This is the brief ideas of the all the tool geometry, and this angle, value of the angles, have to be well controlled and taken into consideration before the machining action is taken place. Thank you.